Hello friend, welcome to my channel. Today's video is about how to rewind a ceiling fan by handwinding modern method. Also thanks to 4DB for helping me in this modern style of rewinding process. Let's hear some winding tips from 4DB as he is an electrical engineer.
So hello guys, I'm 4DB here. So today we will going to see a ceiling fan stator winding. And we will also discuss about some types of windings in the video only. And we will also see, since this is a DIY rewinding of a ceiling fan, so Electro Smarts will show us how to do a rewind of a ceiling fan in a proper way. So the main things of rewinding a fan are the SWG or the thickness of the wire. Generally 35 to 36 SWG is used for ceiling fan. 320 to 340 turns for main winding and 300 to 320 for auxiliary winding is required for a ceiling fan. Maintain the ohms value, means the resistance, by calculating using a multimeter. The auxiliary should be around 150 to 180 ohms and the main winding should be around 180, means 170 to 200 ohms. That will do the job, depending on the size of the fan obviously. So let's get started.
Required material: 36 gauge copper wire, insulating varnish, film paper, marker pen, tin cutter, ruler, forceps, insulation sleeve, size number 1 and 3. Remove the wires out from the connector and discharge the capacitor immediately. Testing the continuity of winding using series test clamp. Let's dismantle the fan motor. In case if the windings are in good condition, we should repair the lead wire for working condition. But in this fan, its windings are became loose and insulation papers are broken. In such cases, if we repair the lead wire, it will result in short circuit of winding. So there is only way to rewind the fan. Now I am removing the old windings out from the stator. After that, measure the thickness of the stator using ruler. Thickness of the stator is 16 mm. For 16 mm stator thickness, I am measuring 24 mm film paper. This is the winding data. Auxiliary winding 340 turn and wire used 30 gauge normal copper wire, not any special grade, and main winding 350 turn, same 30 gauge normal grade wire. stator thickness is equal to 16 millimeter. Fix the stator in a stand or in a bench vise. And then insert the film paper into the slots. Tie the end of the copper wire to the shaft and start winding the first pole in clockwise direction. Size of the film paper should be at least 4 mm larger than the stator thickness. The windings of next pole should be done in anti-clockwise direction. The windings of third pole should be done in clockwise direction. And the most important thing is, it is necessary to spacing the winding gap using forceps for each 50 turns. And then the windings of fourth pole should be done in anti-clockwise direction. The windings of fifth pole should be done in clockwise direction. And then the windings of fixed pole should be done in anti-clockwise direction. After finishing sixth pole, the windings of seventh pole should be done in clockwise direction. Repeat the same process till completing the work. Now I have fully completed the auxiliary winding. Cut the excess paper from the stator. Fold the edges of the film paper and insert the pieces of the film paper in before folded paper. Now let us rewind the main winding by same process. Windings of first pole should be always in clockwise direction. Whether it is main winding or auxiliary winding, the windings of first pole should be always in clockwise direction. The windings of second pole should be done in anti-clockwise direction. And then the windings of third pole should be done in clockwise direction. Repeat the same process till completing the work. The windings of last pole will always be in anti-clockwise direction. And then fold the edges of the film paper. Fix a film paper in between the windings of starting pole and ending pole. Take insulation sleeve of size number 1 and cut it to 4 similar pieces and then insert it into lead wire. For removing enamel from the lead wire, use scissors or small paper cutting knife. Join the common lead wire. Now I have selected 3 different colored wires, blue, black, and red. This is the wiring diagram. Black wire is for common, blue for auxiliary winding, and red for main winding. Insert the wire inside the shaft and pull it out by using forceps. Take insulation sleeve of size number 3. And cut into 3 similar pieces and then insert into connecting wire. Join the lead wire with connecting wire. Black is for common, blue for auxiliary winding, and red for main winding. Cut and remove the excess part of the wire. Ends of the wires should be soldered. Completely close the small sleeve by using larger one. Tie the connecting wire by using tag or poly thread. place a piece of film paper under the connecting wire to prevent short circuit. Apply varnish on the completed winding. For diluting varnish, 50% of thinner should be added before applying. After applying the varnish, dry well in the sun. Finally, I am testing the continuity. Now I am assembling the fan motor. Now I completed the work. Now I am testing the fan.